Welcome to our new CastHeads segment right here on the CastHeads channel. This is CHM News, basically our roundup to kick off your weekend and all diecast related news that's happening online. And hopefully it'll help you influence your purchase decisions over the weekend when you go diecast shopping, because you've seen some nice new diecast cars that you want to get yourself. And we're going to be asking some really tough questions to answers we'll probably not need or we'll never find. So welcome to the new segment. Hope you're having a fantastic Saturday morning. Kicking things off, and this is our version of the teleprompter. It's very high-tech, iPad. Kicking things off, first on our news thing, is the whole quality control debacle that Tarmac Works is going through right now. Now, unfortunately, Tarmac Works released the Super 9 a month ago, and collectors have started to get the product in their hands. And unfortunately, there has been a slew of quality control complaints that have been coming on all Tarmac Works Facebook pages and fan pages around the globe. So what we thought we'd do is, since we are big CastHeads, and we're here for you guys, we thought we'd call up Tarmac Works and ask them what on earth is going on. And this is basically what they sent us, sent back to us.
Hi everyone, this is Felix from Tarmac Works. Thank you to CastHeads for their new video segments. I think it's great that they're doing more videos. I think everyone loves unboxing and just more videos on model cars, and I think they're doing a great job, so thank you for that. And thank you for inviting me to have this video. So basically, I was asked about the recent quality issues with one of our cars, the RWB 993, the Super 9. And like I said in the post in Tarmac Works Global, I think it was, that we're the first to admit when we have a problem, and we do. And we're gonna be honest about it, we're gonna face it. We also had some customer service problems in resources, so this is being taken care of now. Actually, I also sat down for a couple of days in front of the computer nonstop, basically answering emails about any questions about the tracking code and where the shipments are, and also with some of the defect issues. We are getting someone new for the customer service team to be dedicated to responding to questions, and not just because responding to questions is one thing, we definitely have to do it for sure, but it's also reactive. So I want to take it more proactive in a way that how do we avoid or minimize having such issues again at the factory level. And so we've also met with the factory yesterday to discuss this issue. It's basically before the Chinese New Year's, everyone is rushing, and the Super 9 had some issue with the tooling, so we had to fix it. And then due to that, there was a slight delay of a couple of weeks. And then with the Chinese New Year's coming, factory workers are basically off starting next week, and then for 3 weeks. And so everything was rushing, and just again, there's no real excuse, to be honest, and I know how frustrating it is to receive something that has problems, because I collect tons of cars as well, so I'm there with you, and our whole team is. And so we are basically just facing this from a lot of different angles, from the customer service side to the production side, having this person also to do better quality management in terms of reporting on the issues back to the factory and things like this, and how in the factory we can step up the QCs. We talked about having QC labels, for example, on the car, so that the factory workers are responsible for what they have reviewed, and this I think is important. And so, just from a tons of different angles we're looking at, and I'm glad sometimes that problems arises, because it's not only a wake up call, it's also a way for us to focus on where the problems are, and we don't want to just hide it under the rug, and so that's not what we are. So just wanted to take the opportunity to say thank you to those who gave us feedback. Apologize to those who have received the defective items. We're going to do everything to replace it, and if it's not replaceable, of course we'll send you the full refund, but we want to replace it because we know you wanted the car. So we are going to work hard on this. You have my word for it, and our team is as well. And so again, thank you to all the comments and all the feedback, and a lot of people were very understanding as well. So thank you for that, for supporting us and having that patience. Just a very quick word on 2020. We're planting tons of stuff. I spent the past, I think, probably 4 to 6 months just planting a lot of seeds. We're not the quickest brand to come up with products. That's for sure. A couple of reasons for that, but we're not trying to think of the short term. That's not what we are. So what we're trying to do is think about the long term and planning for very cool collaborations, planning for collaborations with motor car companies, and we are going to announce that very, very soon, actually more than one. So and then with very cool brands, and this is something that I'm trying to work on. So a lot of stuff coming. I can't say what they are yet, so just stay in touch with our Instagram and Facebook, and we'll soon have some great news for you. So again, thank you for everything, for all the understanding. We're going to work very hard on the QC stuff and customer service stuff, and to hopefully bring you better cars, better quality cars, better shopping experience, and after sales service. So again, thank you so much, and I gotta get back to work. Thank you.
So we have faith that things are going to be pretty much back to normal, and Tarmac Works after this will have their quality control issues back on track. Unfortunately, not everyone can be pleased, and there will be a few people who are still going to be sore about this. But by and large, quite a few collectors have been fantastic, have understood the problem, and rest assured, you guys are going to be satisfied quite soon. Except, of course, for this guy who dodged a huge bullet. Obviously, the spider that was inside the case was trying to break out, which is why the acrylic case was, broken in the first place. So I think the whole problem with that is that the spider was the one that broke the case. And then can you imagine if the spider didn't die, a spider that strength getting out and biting him?
Of course not.
Very lucky. If you're watching this, man, hope you consider yourself quite a lucky guy for not encountering that spider. Dead spider is much better than a live spider. Apart from that, Tarmac Works has just dropped two much-awaited RWBs, the Jägermeister and the Martini Porsche. Most of you were able to get it in the Tarmac Works Collectors Club. If you were lucky enough to get it online through the web store, good on you. They seem absolutely beautiful, and one thing's for sure, after all this quality control problems, Felix himself is going to be checking out very specifically the roller for these RWBs, being the next ones that get to you. So you can be sure that the ones that come, the Martini and the Jägermeisters, are going to be on point when it comes to quality control. Moving on, Model Car Hall of Fame inductees DNA Collectibles have re-released their winning Volvo P1800. It's in this beautiful red. It's absolutely stunning, same insane details. They've also released pictures of this, which is the V90 cross-country ocean race in pearl white. It's absolutely stunning, and we love that little luggage carry on the top of the Jeep. It's going to be out in May 2020, but you guys can pre-order it on the DNA Collectibles website. Then, Mini GT has declared war on the 164 category with their relentless new slew of new models that they launched at the Tokyo Auto Show last month. Right now, everybody's raving about this, which is the brand new BMW E30 in white. They've got it in red, but we like the white because it's just got that simple of purity, I think. They've got all these other ones that are on the back burner that are going to be coming up, including their Time Attack Civic and this fantastic Pandem. So check it out. They are all on pre-order on the site. Mini GT is going to be rocking the 164 world if this is what the first quarter is looking like. Other 164 brands that have got the internet buzzing is Tomica. They're celebrating 50 years this year, and they're going to be releasing three of their main models. They work very closely with Nissan, Honda, and Toyota, and they're going to be releasing three signature models from their line for the 50th anniversary. So, you know, we certainly can't wait to add the Skyline to our collection, because this Skyline looks absolutely fantastic. Everybody wants it, Tomica breaking the internet. Then Ferrari fans are going to have, they're going to either love this 118 scale or hate it. Purists will probably hate it, but then we certainly love this LB Works Ferrari 308 by GT Spirit with Edward branding. It makes it look like the 308, it makes the 308 look more like Dwayne Johnson and not Magnum PI. But we love the fact that LBW has been jacking up some of these old classic sports cars. We saw the Miura a few months ago, and now we've got the Ferrari 308. Loving it completely, looking forward to getting this one in our hands. Majorette, they've been teasing quite a few pictures of what's going to be happening in 2020. But since CastHeads is on a bit of a German trip right now, we like to call out Majorette for these wonderful Mercedes that they've got coming out, the AMG GTR and the G-Wagon. And what's lovely about the G-Wagon is the fact that the bonnet is openable, and that's what I love about Majorette. They take it a little step further with some of their deluxe model cars. So looking forward to this AMG GTR Green Monster and the G-Wagon. Jada Toys, can't forget about them. They do some wonderful stuff, and they're going to be releasing their big time muscle. If you haven't seen it already, they've got four sexy 124 scale big muscle cars. We've got the classic Vet Stingray, a Pontiac Judge GTO, the 1970 Dodge Starter, and my personal favorite, a black and orange Camaro Z28. Stunning models from Jada. You can have a look at them right here behind me. I hope they're there behind me, otherwise our editing skill has gone to shut to hell. Finally, we got the new Maestro Catalog 2020, absolutely brand spanking new, and Borago Catalog 2020. My producer, Big Bertha, is saying...
Flip the Borago's
okay. We're still getting used to this new segment thing, but yeah, we've got the new catalogs, and one thing I'd like to give you guys a sneak peek into is the haulers and transporters that are coming out. We are really excited about the Mercedes 164 Actros set. The black and gold version is absolutely sweet. The new team haulers look fantastic. My personal favorite being the Falcon set and the Volkswagen set. Can't wait to get our hands on that. And saving the best for last, check out the new 124 scale Elite transport set. I'm sure everyone's going to go crazy over that Datsun pickup and that Nissan Skyline. All the cars look fantastic, all the sets look fantastic, but that Datsun 520 and the Nissan Skyline is definitely going to be one for the books. In fact, I think there's going to be some MDK in the car sets headquarters when that one hits our desk. Because I know for a fact that my partner in crime is going to want to snoop that away from me. Right, that's it for this week. We hope you enjoyed the show. This is the first of what will hopefully be a weekly thing. If we can't keep it up weekly, then we certainly will do it bi-weekly. But we'd like to keep this going. And we would like you to like, subscribe, and share this new segment, because we are going to randomly pick the one who shares the most and the one who likes us the most. Okay, you can't like us the most, then you have to like us one. But if you share us the most and subscribe to us, you have a chance of winning this gorgeous 143 Stella Artois RWB Tarmac Works car. We checked out the QC on this. So far, we see it looks fine. If you have a problem with any of the quality control, just remember, it's